So we finally want to talk about electric cars again, and as always, there's really a lot going on. For one, we might have a final location of the planned Gigafactory 4 in Europe. And yeah, it looks as if it will be the Deutsche Gigafabrik. And talking of Gigafactory, the Gigafactory 3 in Shanghai is undergoing first Model 3 production trial runs.
However, until Chinese-built Model 3s can roll out, Tesla unfortunately first has to raise prices in China. And we want to talk about some other cool stuff, such as the price parity between EVs and petrol cars by 2023, a giant self-charging mining truck, and the return of the outlandish Aptera 2E, and our thoughts on Tesla's current service problems. So stay tuned!
Okay, now admittedly, the last 2 weeks were a bit more space intensive, but we also don't want to forget about our good old electric cars. Because we on this channel are of course huge EV fans, and the transition to sustainable transport is one of the other big problems that we have to solve in the 21st century, apart from colonizing other worlds. So we now have the news that apparently the location for the planned Gigafactory 4 is closing in on Saxony in Germany. And actually up to 2,000 jobs will be created by the Gigafactory 4, which is planned to open in 2021. So it looks like the traditional automakers in Germany might probably have to cut back jobs because they have to transition to electric cars. But fortunately, the people who might lose their jobs will find new jobs working for Tesla at the Gigafactory 4. And we are pretty sure that some German manufacturers will not survive the transition to electric cars in the 2020s. So Germany in the year 2030, it might actually happen that many German people working in the auto industry are working for foreign companies, maybe CATL or Tesla, having huge gigafactories on German soil. Certainly an interesting vision for the year 2030 in Germany.
In China, on the other hand, the first Model 3 trial runs are already starting in the Gigafactory 3, with the first real pre-production models starting to roll off the assembly line. The first completely Chinese-built Model 3 was shown at the World Artificial Intelligence Conference on the 29th of August in Shanghai. Full production will start in November, with 3,000 Model 3s estimated to be produced weekly by year's end. We think the Model 3 will conquer China by storm. Until then, however, a weakening yuan is forcing Tesla to increase the price of all Tesla models in China as early as in September. And in December, another price hike is expected due to the trade war, since Chinese tariffs are planned to go into effect by then. However, since Model 3s will be produced in Giga 3 by November, which are of course exempt from trade tariffs, we think Tesla is just right on time to be able to absorb the blow it would have received due to the trade tariffs. Perfect timing! Even more, it seems that now all Tesla models are exempt from sales tax effective immediately in China, which will certainly also boost their sales there. Bam!
Now, when we last talked about electric cars, we made the prediction that according to logistics S-curve growth, by 2040 at the latest, we would see 90% market penetration of electric cars. Many people in the comments section actually said that we might even be too pessimistic, and we actually tend to agree that this might actually happen sooner than expected, maybe even by 2030. Now, according to a futurist named Ray Wills, who is the managing director of an advisory firm called Future Smart Strategies, price parity of electric cars with gasoline cars can already be reached in 2023. And this might then be already the tipping point where buying an electric car will start making more sense than a gasoline car also for the vast majority of people. Because let's not forget, what does average Joe care about? The environment? Cleaner air? Reducing greenhouse gas emissions? No, of course not. Price. The price. So when EVs start to become as expensive or less expensive than gasoline cars while offering the same or better features, then people will really start switching over to electric cars in masses, and this will be the tipping point where electric car growth really takes off exponentially. And Wills goes further, saying that by 2026 already, electric cars will be cheaper and better than gasoline cars in every respect, including range, and gasoline cars will become completely obsolete, with many manufacturers completely abandoning gasoline cars.
Then the flip will happen, and we might actually reach 90% market penetration of EVs already by 2030. This is how disruption works. It's a highly non-linear process. That's why so many people have difficulties to imagine it, because our brains are really bad at understanding exponential growth. It starts slowly, but then before you realize it, bang! Then we also want to talk about this cool EV here, currently being operated in Switzerland. A giant mining truck, to be precise, produced by the machinery manufacturer Kuhn. And what's the amazing thing about it? It almost never has to be charged. Now, how is that possible? Simple, it employs the full power of regenerative braking. It drives up a hill to pick up limestones from a quarry, weighing dozens of tons. It then drives the same way downhill again. And it's freaking recharging, recuperating now more energy, since the potential energy of the truck has been increased, which then in turn increases the kinetic energy. Thus, it almost never has to be charged. This beast packs a ginormous 600 kWh battery pack, by the way. And the truck alone saves 50,000 metric tons of diesel annually. Now that's a lot of diesel that can be saved that way. And Kuhn plans to electrify all mining trucks in the future. We cannot wait to see this happen.
In other news, a car seems to be returning now that I first read about already 10 years ago, and which makes me super happy that it kind of returns from the dead now. So we're talking about the super outlandish styled Aptera 2E, which was already revealed back in 2009 as far as I remember. But then the company encountered financial problems back in 2011 and the Aptera completely vanished from the electric car scene. But now it seems that Aptera is really back again from the dead, and they really seem to be planning to bring the 2E finally to the market. Now, the aerodynamic drag coefficient of this thing is probably insanely low, certainly below 0.2, even though we have no exact number, but we can guess maybe 0.18 or something like this. And it will come in battery pack sizes ranging from 40 kilowatt hours even to 100 kilowatt hours. Now, in addition to being super aerodynamic, the car is also very lightweight. And in combination with this very large battery packs, it would enable a range of up to 1,000 miles, 1,600 kilometers of range. That is absolutely insane. Now, how is that for range anxiety? That pretty much absolutely destroys any range anxiety. Let's see if they make it to market this time, and we certainly hope yes, because this is a very interesting electric car. And it looks insanely futuristic too, which we always like, of course. And then we also want to talk about a not so pleasant topic, but it has to be. It's about Tesla's current service problems. We as Tesla fanboys and girls, I mean, we love Tesla, but we certainly also have to talk about the negative things. We don't want to pretend like Tesla never does anything wrong. Everything Tesla does is super amazing and they never do any mistakes. So we also want to talk about this, of course, and don't want to hide the negative things that are going on. So the story we want to talk about is that the German car rental company called NextMove wanted to order 100 Model 3s to increase their electric car rental fleet.
The whole story is a bit too long and complicated to present it in full detail, but long story short, it only took delivery of 15 Model 3s, which already had quite some issues, such as faulty wiring, scratches on the dashboard, defective tail lights, defective turn signals, or condensation in the headlights. When NextMove was raising concerns about quality towards Tesla, Tesla apparently was getting annoyed and cancelled the rest of the order. We have to say, not cool, Tesla. The only thing we currently also don't like on how Tesla is doing stuff are the service problems. Okay, sure, Tesla is a startup that has nothing less as a goal than transition us to sustainable transport as soon as possible. And that of course means making some sacrifices regarding quality. Our Model 3 performance, for example, also has a not perfectly mounted spoiler, where we are still waiting for a replacement, half a year later. We also had a taillight problem, but that one was fixed pretty fast. We of course tried to ignore the problems because we want to support the noble cause. But the way Tesla currently treats its customers that encounter issues with their Model 3s is really unacceptable. So we can absolutely understand NextMove, especially them being a car rental company and having responsibilities towards their customers. So yeah, Tesla really needs to improve in that department. Here, we said it, we also want to talk about the negative things. It's unpleasant, but it has to be.
Now that being said, we of course still love Tesla and we will always continue to support Tesla despite the problems they have. Now, why will we always continue to support Tesla? Well, who started the electric car revolution? Was it GM? Was it BMW? Was it VW? No, it was only Tesla who started the electric car revolution. And who forced all the legacy car makers now to switch to electric cars? Only Tesla. And who is accelerating our transition to renewable, sustainable transport? Only Tesla. No one else. Because the legacy car makers would probably have continued to pump out polluting, stinking diesels. They would have probably continued to sell us their gas guzzlers and stinking diesels that pollute us and kill us slowly, probably still in the year 2100, after the sea level would have risen probably by 70 meters and all the coastal cities in the world would be drowned by the sea level rise. Even then they would have continued to sell us their stinking gasoline and diesel cars. And for that, we will always support Tesla, even if sometimes they might have some servicing problems, even if sometimes the cars are not in 100% perfect condition, even if there are some minor faults that have to be fixed afterwards, we don't care, we still will support them. Because Tesla is one of the single most important companies of the last, 100 years. But we'll always continue also to talk about the negative aspects of Tesla.
So what do you think about all these Tesla service problems? Have you had similar experiences?
And are you as idealistic as we are to support them despite the problems they have sometimes?
So where would be your limit? Where would you stop supporting Tesla?
If the car would have maybe only one wheel instead of four, that would be not so good. Then I would say, Tesla, you have gone a bit too far.
That's a simple limit.
Yeah.
And if you're new to this channel, we do weekly space and EV news and talk about interesting upcoming technologies.
So be sure to subscribe and maybe even share it with your friends, and see you in the next video.